And this is the back of the Drawworks. The motor would be sitting here. Screw in hand tight only. Once that has been completed, remove pressure from the brakes. Brake pressure should go from 2300 psi to 0 psi. Using a 2¾-inch wrench with either a ratcheting style wrench or a breaker bar, we will adjust the piston in and out to ensure that we have 60 thou gap between the brake pad and the brake disc. In the load lowering toolbox where we found the sockets, you will also find a shim set. It's 2 × 30 thou or 60 thou total, which is 1.5 millimeters. When using the shim set, ensure that the shims are together and not spread apart. If they are spread like that, you don't get an accurate reading. Ensure that they are together, and when you're inserting the shim, you insert it in the center area of the brake. If I measure on the outside, now we're going to go loosening. Here, I will not receive an accurate reading. I must always measure in the middle. And I keep going, I turn clockwise to go in and counterclockwise to go out. And until it's just snug, you should just be able to pull in and out. You can feel the snugness. And we can go in a little bit more. little bit more. Tighten, please.
Tight?
Yes. And just until we get, until she starts grabbing. And that's enough. And we will do that to all 8 caliper halves. So we have 1, 2, and then on the other side, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then on the other side, 7 and 8. All 8 caliper halves must be adjusted at the same time. So using this wrench or breaker bar, we turn clockwise, lifting this to push the piston and brake pad in. You'll turn counterclockwise, pushing this down to loosen the brake. Using the shim set, you'll feel just until it's snug. If it goes very easily in the middle, it's too loose. Now, once we've achieved 2300 PSI as our brake pressure, the retaining nuts in the center there and there should be able to come off again by hand very easily. If one is slightly difficult to move, you can use the same wrench just to loosen it off until you can go by hand again. All 8 caliper halves must have the retaining nuts, the retaining bolts, removed and replaced back into the load lowering toolbox. Once you have removed all retaining nuts, put back the thread guards both large and small and using the Allen keys we'll tighten them. This is done on all locations at the same time, or one after another. And your brake adjustment is now complete.